when you guys think of these "this is how powerful this character is" videos, the series that usually come to mind are Dragon Ball, or My Hero Academia, or Marvel. But I'm going to be focusing on a really underrated franchise, and that is Disgaea. To be more specific, I'm going to be focusing on the protagonist of the fifth game, Disgaea 5, and that is Killia. And Killia is actually a very powerful character, and is one of, if not the most powerful character in Disgaea. So, I'm going to give you an idea of just how powerful he is. Now, just a quick thing to note before we move on, I'd just like to point out that Killia himself doesn't really have any feats, and more relies on scaling to other characters to show his true power. So, I just wanted to let you know that before we get into. So, if you're looking for feats and stuff like that, you're not going to find much of it, because it's more so comparing Killia to other characters. But without further ado, let's begin. So, before we get into Killia himself, we need to focus on other demons. As I said before, he more so scales to other characters. In Disgaea D2, A Brighter Darkness, Laharl ends up doing this.
Surprised! I destroyed every star in sight!
But after he destroys those stars, his vassal Etna shows up talking about how this isn't all impressive.
Anyway, Prince, most demons can destroy the stars, you know. You can destroy as many stars as you want, but no one will accept you as the Overlord just for that.
So this means that even the weaker demons and the weakest level demons can actually destroy stars, as the feat is stated to not really be that impressive. And even if you don't want to take that into account, several demons in all the different games can destroy stars, planets, and sometimes even the entire universe using their specials, backing up the point that the weaker level demons are at the very least star level. And you might be asking why this is relevant? Well, in the beginning of the game, Disgaea 5, Killia actually takes out a bunch of lower level demons, but these demons are actually quite special, as they are members of the Lost, an elite army run by Void Dark. So they at least need to be hitting these star levels of power for Void Dark to consider having them in his army. And Killia just casually, in base form, just completely erases them, with absolutely no difficulty. So this would at least need to make Killia a star level or high star level at the beginning of the game, and he is far stronger than that. Killia's next big feat comes when he takes on an overlord known as Red Magnus. Now, the title of an overlord isn't something easily earned, and you need to be very powerful in order to take that title. In fact, it needs to be at least comparable or stronger than Dark Death Evil Man. Now, Dark Death Evil Man is an overlord in his own right, and is actually considered to be, in canon, one of the weakest overlords in existence. Which means, in order for Red Magnus to be classified as an overlord, he would need to be, at the very least, as strong as Dark Death Evil Man. And in terms of power, Dark Death Evil Man was able to destroy a galaxy with zero effort. So in order for a character to be able to be classed as an overlord, they need to be at least as strong as that, meaning they need to be at least galaxy level. And Killia is fighting this guy one-on-one. And Red Magnus even backs it up, saying, "You're about to fight me one-on-one and you're doing this." Proving that he did actually fight Red Magnus one-on-one. You could argue that Seraphina helped. However, Seraphina wasn't really into fighting and didn't really do much fighting at that point in the game. It was more so Killia just doing the work for her. However, that is not Killia's most impressive power and is not him at his best. His best comes when he fights Void Dark at the end of the game. And this is actually quite impressive, as Void Dark is a very powerful character as well. For example, in the middle of the game, or at one point in the game, he actually fires out a blast, kills a bunch of high-level demons, which are beyond star level, and that causes the entire Neverworld that they're in to shake, as each Neverworld is its own separate universe. So, he just casually shakes a Neverworld, which is like a real-sized universe. He does that with just a single blast, and Killia ends up defeating him. Granted, he was with the rest of the Rebel Army, and it is implied that they took part in the battle. However, Killia did most of the work, as he's the strongest, and was actually the one that finished him off. But what's most impressive about Void Dark is at the end of the game, Void Dark says himself that he has enough power to destroy all the Neverworlds in existence. Now, what's interesting about this is that, since I said before, each Neverworld is its own universe, and there are implied to be thousands upon thousands of Neverworlds, and Void Dark was going to destroy them all. Also, this is also backed up as after Void Dark dies, his energy starts to go out of control, and then they need to stop it or all the Neverworlds are going to be wiped out. As Killia and other characters even state, yeah, if we let this happen, every Neverworld in existence is going to be destroyed, and each Neverworld is contained in its own universe, which means the Void Dark would at least need to be multiversal level in order to destroy all this, and Killia easily scales to this, as Killia took him down in his base form. And that's not even counting his super form, Tyrant Revelio. I'm probably pronouncing that wrong. But in this form, Killia gained a massive buff, as he went from being able to barely contend against Void Dark's general in his base form to being able to match him blow for blow. And this guy was pretty powerful in his own right, so Killia's super form allowed him to jump from being able to barely contend to this guy to being able to match him in power. So, there's no official multiplier for the form, but I'd honestly have to give the form a 10 times multiplier at the very least in order for Killia to jump up that much. I think that's a fair assessment of his power. So yeah, that's pretty much all the feats for Killia in terms of power, being able to, you know, defeat a multiversal threat mostly on his own. But Killia also has quite a few hacks at his disposal as well. Mostly his Macrocosm attack, which actually pushes him beyond his limits. And when he used it against Void Dark came back, but his evil was gone. After he got hit by that attack, he came back as his old self. Which shows that Killia might have some sort of evil cleansing power, or the attack might be super effective against evil people, kind of like a spirit bomb, or like holy weapons. But that's a bit debatable, and you can interpret that as how you want to interpret it. I'll also go over a couple more stats in case anyone wants to know. Killia is easily one of the fastest of the Rebel Alliance or the Rebel Army, and is only slightly slower than Zorokin. Killia himself is easily comparable and much faster than other weaker demons that can fly between star systems in seconds, and is actually taken down and actually pretty much speed blitz characters like Laharl. And Laharl himself could react to Dark Death Eagle Man's attack, which destroyed the galaxy in 1/13 of a second, easily making Laharl quadrillions of times the speed of light, and Killia basically speed blitzed him. Like, Killia wasn't even trying, and Laharl spent the rest of the DLC to get Killia to try and take Laharl seriously and actually, you know, fight back against him and not just dodge his attacks. So this would easily make Killia in his base form quadrillions of times the speed of light. As for durability, he was able to take hits from Void Dark, so his durability is most likely the same as his attack potency. So yeah, that's all of Killia's stats covered. In terms of power, he's hitting multiversal to maybe massively multiversal and multiversal plus in his super form. In terms of speed, he's quadrillions to quintillions of times the speed of light, and in terms of durability, he's about the same. And yeah, that's pretty much all there is to Killia, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Remember to like, share, and subscribe, and if you want me to do more videos, like in this type of genre, please let me know. I have an Endeavor video planned, so that might be coming soon if that's something you guys are interested in, but I'd like to thank you guys for watching one more time, and hope you guys have a great day.